Alex Rexroad is on the line with us. He's the executive director of iSave Team, Union for Mechanical Insulation. The website is iSaveTeam.org. And just an acknowledgement that the iSave Team is one of the sponsors, one of the underwriters for this program. And Alex, welcome to the program.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it, Tom.
Thanks for joining us. This is what you guys are doing, I think, is really cool stuff in as much as you're working to reduce the carbon footprint of America. Tell us about it. What is iSave Team? What are you guys doing?
Well, the iSave Team is a consortium of contractors and installers who in the U.S. and Canada who install mechanical insulation. And mechanical insulation, loosely translated, means that it's materials that are placed over mechanical systems that reduce heat gain or heat loss. Mm-hmm. And when you do that, you reduce consumption of energy. And when you do that, you reduce the carbon footprint of whatever the service is, whether it's an oil refinery or your home, frankly.
Right. So Alec, I'm sorry, I was calling you Alex.
That's okay. All my lifetime.
Okay. How did iSaveTeam.org come about?
Well, actually, it came about because we felt the need to market our services in the U.S. and Canada. And we had never done that before. This industry has been around since the late 1800s, and we always just kind of stayed under the radar. Mm-hmm. But we believed it was important to start, and especially with the election of Barack Obama, because the president said we need to worry about energy consumption in this country and footprint, greenhouse gas emissions. And so we decided we should be part of that conversation. In doing that, we started to promote mechanical insulation on Capitol Hill, along with radio stations like yours, along with some other media, print media in particular. And the idea was to get people to start understanding what we do. And we're very small by comparison, but we are very big in terms of savings and greenhouse gas emission reductions. So in the 111th Congress, we started to promote mechanical insulation to the Congress. And believe me, very few people knew what we did.
Now, am I correct in assuming when you say mechanical insulation that you're talking about things like, you know, wrapping fiberglass around heating and cooling ducts or putting foam insulation around hot water pipes or cold water pipes for that matter to maintain the integrity of the temperature in those things that are moving heat around in our buildings?
That's exactly right. Not necessarily fiberglass, obviously. There are numerous different materials for different services. Mm-hmm. But fiberglass is one of them, and there are a myriad of other ones. But yes, the end result of that is to once you put that material over that hot pipe, you stop the heat loss or reduce it dramatically. I mean, reduce it to from 0 to 92-93% if you do it properly.
Whoa. Now,
the numbers are huge, Tom.
Yeah, yeah. My best friend lives in New York City, and he had to move out of his apartment this week because the building is 60 some odd years old, and they are taking out all the asbestos right now that was associated with the hot water pipes that were bringing heat to the radiator in his living room and bedroom. Is that the kind of stuff you guys do too, coming in maybe after the asbestos removal and re-insulating, or?
We will do both.
Oh,
we will do the re-insulation, and probably in New York, there's probably somebody, one of our contractors is probably involved in that process. Yeah. May also be involved in the asbestos removal process. I mean, back in the 60s, when I first started in this industry, we were putting on asbestos. And now we found that it's probably not a good idea that we leave it in place. And so we are in the process of removing it in a lot of cases.
Yeah, it can be.
But we do the re-insulation as well.
That's great. Yeah, it's nasty stuff. My father died from mesothelioma. I'm real familiar with that.
Oh, my. Yeah. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, well,
I am. I wear a bracelet right now that says, believe in a cure for meso. That's how important it is to us.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we had him taking turmeric extract, curcumin, and I think it extended his life substantially. But that's a whole other conversation.
That is.
Yeah. We're talking with Alex Rexroth, who is the executive director of the iSave Team Union for Mechanical Insulation. The website is isaveteam.org. Alec, thanks so much for dropping by, and thanks for the great work you're doing.
Well, you're welcome, and thank you for giving us the opportunity. We really appreciate it.
It's a pleasure and great talking.